That start was okay. Now stay alert for threats around you. Next time you come in. Thank you. These conditions are making the line a bit greasy, but we're still nowhere near the changeover point. Is pitting. Thank you. was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops.
Thank you.
distance to the leader is 10.6 seconds. So the gap to our teammate is 5.5 seconds. Situation is an interesting one, but I think the right call is to stick with what we've got right now. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Behind is 2.9 seconds. A few left. This is your final lap of the race. Stay with us for at least 20 minutes, maybe more. Light rain is here to stay. Great drive. We're really happy with that performance.
Brilliant stuff from Mercedes today. That's another historic win. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
Well, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean, we could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres, but at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed over everyone else, and that's exactly what they had today.
So as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out now to collect their trophies. It's yet more silverware to take back to their base in Brackley after another excellent Grand Prix. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. It's a good result for Valtteri Bottas, who extends his advantage at the top of the championship. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Well, Jolyon Palmer did a great job coming through the field today, so my vote goes to him.
On to the constructors then. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. Meanwhile, Toro Rosso's strong weekend allows them to continue their march up the table. After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.